Welcome back to my project. This is Eric. The Wi-Fi connection in the MCU has allowed us to do many projects that we couldn't do before. Connecting directly to the server and transferring data is now a piece of cake. You agree with me, don't you? I hope we are on the same page. Now, the way I see it, I can do various projects even in an environment without Wi-Fi by using a cellular modem beyond Wi-Fi. The device I will use in this project is based on ESP32S3 and includes a mini PCIe 4G LTE modem as well as a camera module over Genesis 40. This is very interesting. As you know, ESP32S3 already includes Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. By combining this with the PCIe type LTE modem, this can be connected to server anytime, anywhere. Unfortunately, Wi-Fi isn't there when we really need it. LTE also doesn't cover all of the US, but we believe that excluding satellite service guarantees the maximum connectivity we can use. In today's project, I'm going to start a project that captures images and uploads them to the server. Personally, what I'm most excited about is how quickly the images can be sent to the server. The SIM 7600H series I will be using is an LTE Cat 4 module and supports up to 150 Mbps downlink rate and 50 Mbps uplink rate. It means you can upload files at 6.25 megabytes per second. That's awesome. However, there are just the specification of the LTE module. Here is the problem. The MCU and LTE module are connected via UART and the data is transferred through it. This is likely to be significantly slower than the USB interface. The second problem is the packet size that can be sent at a time. Ethernet's MTU is usually 1500 bytes. This is the size of the packets that can be transferred at a time. TinyGSM, which we will use, does not seem to break into the chunk when the size of the data to be transferred is larger than the MTU. That's why we need to create and transmit packets in the chunk unit. For example, let's say your 40 image is 300 kilobytes. It cannot be uploaded to the server at once through the POST API. This is because it exceeds the MTU size. So this is divided into chunk units with a maximum packet size of 1500 bytes and transferred. Unfortunately, this slows down the transfer rate. If your project is sending short strings to the server, there is no problem at all. What I'm trying to do is to upload the highest quality images that can be taken from over Genesis 40 to the server. Now that the hardware is ready, let's prepare the required SIM card next. I'm using Google Fi, so I was able to easily apply for an additional data-only SIM card and use it. The cost is $10 per gigabyte. That's pretty high rate. However, since it is pay-as-you-go, if you do not use it, it's $0. I think it can be used much cheaper than a prepaid data SIM card that is only used for a few days. There are many variables depending on what kind of project you are doing, so please find the cheapest carrier that is perfect for your case. My Google Fi data SIM card has arrived. It took about 5 days to be delivered. There is a secret code to activate the SIM card in this paper case. You can use it after activating the SIM card through the Google Fi webpage. Now let's get down to the first project by inserting the SIM card into the slot. First, there is a source code provided by the company that made this board. This is very useful to check if your device is working normally. You can test not only the camera but also built-in microphone, so please refer to it if you need a basic understanding of this device. What I'm going to do is test whether I can actually communicate with the server using the TinyGSM library. This is the most important part of this project, so we must confirm it and move on to the next step. Alright, let me open my Arduino IDE. If you have installed the TinyGSM library, you can find an example called all functions from your Arduino IDE. The version I'm currently using is 0.11.5. This example contains many tasks on your SIM module. If you look here, you can test not only GPRS but also Wi-Fi, core, and GPS. I will modify some parts of this code so that my device can work. I use the SIM 7000 series, so select SIM 7600 here. Click connect to hardware serial, not software serial. Define GPIO to which PCIe is connected. This was brought from the T-SIMCAM test code. I will only test the TCP connection after connecting GPRS, so I changed all the rest of the tests to false. Google Fi's APN is H2G2. You need to set it to the APN of the SIM card you use. Lastly, it is to create a serial connection for the modem. This part is also brought from the example source of T-SIMCAM. I believe we are ready for the cellular connection test. Let's see what the results come out. Almost forgot it. You have to enable USB CDC on boot. If not, you cannot see any log from the device. Modem SIM 7600GH connecting to H2G2, GPRS status connected, CCID IMEI, operator Google Fi, HTTP server connected. I got 568 characters from the connected server. Yes, if you see this TinyGSM on the console, your modem works properly. You must check the cellular connection, otherwise you will not be able to proceed with the following steps. In projects using Wi-Fi, it was easy to transfer data to a PC connected to the same local network. However, in an environment using cellular, on the contrary, it's difficult to access the local network or local server. Of course, it's possible, but requires extra routing work. This is a system I'm trying to create this time. It's to make it possible to transfer the pictures taken on T-SIMCAM directly to the server. I will install a server that has a static IP so that we can upload the photos directly through cellular. I will create a VM instance through the Google Cloud platform. Put your instance name here, Ubuntu server. I will make a tiny Ubuntu server here. Choose your region that is cheap and close to you. Since this is a server where you can simply upload and store images, I will choose the E2 Micro as it has the lowest performance. As I said, I will make a Ubuntu server, so let me choose the Ubuntu OS. The version I choose is 18.04 LTS. Allow all HTTP and HTTPS traffic. I think it's done. Okay, my Ubuntu server is created on GCP. We can connect to the server through the console, but I will use the browser's SSH for convenience. I'm on the server. Let's change the font size to maximum. Hopefully you can read these texts well. I will make a Node.js server, which is very simple, so let me download the Node.js. It's time to install Node.js. Installation is done. Let's check the version information to make sure it's installed properly. Oops, it's not Node.js, just Node. I confirmed it works for not only npm but also Node. Now we need to create a Node.js server. The role of this server is to act as an HTTP server, and it must allow image data to be transferred in the post method, and then it's to write image files in the specific folder. You know what? I'm trying to make this server through ChatGPT. I won't go into detail about this because it's very trendy these days. It's gonna be super exciting. Let's get started. Write a Node.js server code to upload images via HTTP post. Wow, it's generating code. Very cool. It allows me to upload an image using the post method with the express module. I feel like it's a very good tutor. Okay, he's good, but I need something more. This time, I will tell him to use a file stream. It's generating the code the way I want. That's sick. I think it understands exactly what I want. Finally, let me add one more thing I need. Change the file name to Unix timestamp in this code. This is a code for the Node.js server I wanted. Perfect. I will copy this as is and use it on my server. I will go back to the server and create a file called server.js and paste the server code created by ChatGPT into it. That's it, I didn't touch anything. This server code used the file system module, so I will install it through npm. Let me run the node server. Server listening on port 3000. Also, this server writes the image files in the upload folder, so we need to make it first. I believe the last part we have to set is the firewall settings. The server uses port num 3000, so we need to set it to allow. In the firewall menu, create firewall rule. Put the rule name, my server port. Set the targets. All instances in the network. I have only one instance, so it doesn't matter. If not, you can choose the instance you want. Source IP version 4 ranges. Allow all IPs. Finally, we are here. We need to add the port num we want here. That's it. My server is ready to go. I need to get a server IP address because I will put in my source code for T-SIMCAM. This is a source code I prepared. After TinyGSM cellular connection, take a picture and send it to the server. I shared this source code through my GitHub repository. Nothing special. After transferring the image file, do nothing for 10 seconds and repeat again. In this part, the data is cut into chunks and transferred. The size of the chunk is set to 1500 bytes. And the frame size is UXGA, which is the maximum resolution of OV Unix 40. Let me build and flash it to my device. Now my server is running. The device takes a picture after connecting to cellular and starts sending it right away. It seems it's currently being uploaded. Let's check if the file was created in the uploads folder. Image file has been sent. Great. The sender's byte and the receiver's byte are the same. It took about 12 seconds to transfer about 120 kilobytes. It shows a very slow transfer rate than expected. Let's stay like this for a few minutes. As you can see, the image is continuously uploaded to the server. How about picture quality? Let's download one image file stored on the server. You can download any files as long as you know the image path. There is a typo. Let me type it again. Here you are. The image shows a lot of noise. Actually, this is my problem. And there is very little light as only one light is on in the room. I think I would have gotten much better results if I had tested it outdoors in the daytime. Let's sum up today's project. We were able to create a system that could upload images taken via cellular to our server. The server was made with Node.js and ChatGPT made it instead of me. The actual upload speed was measured at about 80 kilobits per second, but this part needs to be tested again. I will prepare an application using this. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.